Alright, what's up internet? Today, pag-usapan natin yung mga bagong B55 mobos from ASRock. And parang part 2 to nung series natin kasi nakagawa na ako nung unang video. We have no favorites here at Hardware Sugar. Kung gusto mo Intel, no problem. Kung gusto mo AMD, no problem. It's only fair na tingnan rin natin yung mga bagong B55 mobos na para sa AMD naman. And thank you to our friends at ASRock for lending us these boards in advance. To be honest, natuwa ako na, you know, we got the chance to play around with them. And again, if you watched my first video, you know, I don't really get excited about motherboards kasi parang madaling ma-hype sa CPU, sa GPU, kahit yung RAM may RGB or something. But yung motherboard sobrang mahalaga, but at the same time, medyo mahirap na, oh yes, may bagong motherboard. But as I mentioned in the first video, may mga features yung ASRock motherboards na nakaka-excite naman. These are the things I kind of focused on when I looked at both the Intel and the AMD motherboards. Pero bago nun, you need to know that lahat to B55 mobos and yung mga B55s, compatible lang sila sa 3rd gen pataas na Ryzen. This is sort of an exception and it kind of doesn't make sense and it's kind of annoying na ginawa to ni AMD. Kasi dati simple lang, AM4 lahat ng Ryzen, AM4 socket. Kung 1st gen, 2nd gen, 3rd gen, upcoming 4th gen, lahat yan AM4 socket. Tapos sa motherboard naman, lahat yun AM4 socket din. Yung rule of thumb, basta pareho yung socket ng CPU at pareho yung socket ng motherboard, compatible yan. Yes, there were rare exceptions dahil hindi na-update yung BIOS and things like that. But general rule, kung AM4 socket, pwede sa AM4 motherboard. Pero ngayon sa mga B55s, AM4 yung 2nd gen Ryzen, AM4 yung motherboards, yung B55, pero hindi na sila compatible. It's just one of those things, if you're buying a B55, you need to know na for 3rd gen Ryzen lang sila pataas. And even then, I think I've heard some reports na hindi sila compatible dun sa Ryzen na may integrated graphics, so yung may G sa dulo. Yung 3200G, tsaka yung 3400G. Hindi lang ako sigurado kung lahat to ng B55s and if this has been cleared up in a BIOS update for those mobos. But I remember may mga balita nung bagong-bago si B55 na uy, yung may integrated graphics or onboard graphics sa hindi gagana. You do need to check if you're buying a B55 that number one, you're getting a 3rd gen Ryzen. And number two, you are getting one with onboard graphics. Siguraduhin mo na compatible siya dun sa B55 board na bibilin mo. So that's in general for all B55s, regardless kung ASRock yun, kung ASUS, MSI, Gigabyte, all of the B55s para sa 3rd gen Ryzen lang sila pataas. But we have 3 boards for you, all from ASRock today, and we'll start out with 2 na kamukhang kamukha, as in they look virtually identical. That's the B55 Extreme 4 and the B55 PG or Phantom Gaming Velocita. Behind me is the Extreme 4 and you'll notice it has this nice dark blue finish to it or nice blue accents in the base of the motherboard. And then the Velocita, naka-ano naman yan, parang naka-Italian race car na red. So red naman yung highlights niya, mas gray-red kaysa sa black-blue. But both of them have a very similar design. Let's start out with the caps. Both of them have Japanese Nichikon or Nichikon caps, but to mahalaga. Isa sa mga pangunahing trabaho ng motherboard is to deliver the right power, the right amount, to the right place, to the right component, at the right time. Tinitingnan ng mga medyo tech enthusiasts kung ano bang capacitors yung gamit ng motherboard at kung ano yung quality. Because the capacitors are a big part of what allows the motherboard to send power to the right place in the right amount at the right time. And so Japanese caps are basically the top of the line. And you can see them actually on the motherboard here on the side and then here again. So it's a good sign for the longevity and reliability of this motherboard na it uses itong Japanese caps, yung Nichikon caps. One small thing that I appreciated was both boards have a power button on the motherboard as well as a reset button. Gumawa ako nung video na pinakita ko yung personal rig ko at sobrang luma na, sira na yung power button ng case. So yung ginagamit ko yung power button ng motherboard. It doesn't seem like a big thing, but believe me, pag nanun ka na sa sitwasyon na yun, sobrang laking tulong na may power button sa motherboard. Kung wala, you can always jump it. You can, you know, you can take a screwdriver and then stick it between the pins, and then that will jump start the motherboard. Pero sobrang hassle nun, especially if you need to do it every day. Malaking tulong na may power button dun sa motherboard mismo. And may error code na rin silang dalawa. So there's a small display, and if things are not booting up, the display will give you a code. So again, very easy for troubleshooting. It's these little touches that, you know, make you appreciate the motherboards. Kung di ka builder, hindi mo masyadong iniisip kasi iba masistress figuring out na ba't ayaw mag-boot up. You know, if you're a builder or you're looking to doing your own builds, sobrang laking tulong na may error code display and pati na rin yung power button on the motherboard. Tapos itong si Velocita and si Extreme 4, they both have that. For both of them, their PCBs are made out of 2 ounces of copper. Supposedly, the copper in the PCB allows for better circuits and, you know, again, better pathways for all of that power that the motherboard needs to transport to the different components. Another thing I appreciated a lot was that both boards come with 4 RGB headers, or it's 2 RGB headers and 2 ARGB headers. For me, this is always a mark of a premium board. I mean, again, it sounds like a small thing, pero this is really useful for yung mga builders na hindi pa ganun kasanay sa RGB. May nakita lang na RGB product, ay gusto ko yan, binili. Tapos di nila na tanong kung ARGB ba to, or 5V 3-pin, or 12V 4-pin, which is RGB. Nakakalito talaga. Even us here at the shop, when we do our builds, nakakainis pag maraming RGB re-request si customer, tapos kulang yung RGB header sa motherboard. So, inisip pa namin na paano to, pwede pa to palitan, kung ito, i-daisy chain na lang dito. It's a big help to have 2 ARGB headers and 2 RGB headers. Mas nakatulong dun sa medyo hindi pinansin masyado. Mumili ka lang ng RGB, wala kang pake kung ARGB, RGB. And with these boards, you don't need to worry kasi either option, nandyan na sa board. Pwede may plug in. It's one less headache you need to worry about. Kasi sa totoo lang, malaking problema yan. Ilang customers na nagtanong sa amin na, uy, bumili ako nito, tapos hindi pala gumagana. And you know, there are all sorts of products like RGB converters na para mapagana yung ARGB sa RGB header. You know, with these boards, all of those headaches are solved because they come with not one, but 2. RGB header and 2 ARGB headers. It's really the small things, and I appreciate these things about the ASRock Mobos. Yung next feature na nagustuhan ko, pareho din dun sa Intel motherboards nila, supposedly, or they market their PCIe slots as steel reinforced. Again, I don't really know if there's steel inside those slots, pero it's true, pag sinubukan mo yung clasp nila, yung switch nila dun sa ilalim, yung pang-lock dun sa graphics card or whatever you put in the PCIe slot, the feel is very sturdy, it's very robust. You feel na, yes, ito kahit malaki yung graphics card ko, kaya niya, di ka natatakot, you know, bibigay yung PCIe slot. Ganon din sa Intel motherboards sila, ganon din sa mga bagong B55 motherboards ni ASRock. So supposedly the chokes are rated at 60 amp. The chokes are one of those motherboard features that allow them to deliver power accurately and reliably. So the chokes at 60 amps is not bad for these boards, and they contribute to the reliability of the power transfer. There are also multiple headers for fans. There are 5 fan headers, which also double up or can be used as water pump headers in case you are thinking of water cooling your rig. And 5 is very generous for a motherboard. Again, this is a common problem. People want to add fans to their cases. Not kahit hindi nga RGB, basta regular fans lang. Pero naubusan sila ng headers sa motherboard. So ayun, hanap na naman ng power hub or some other way kung i-daisy chain ba lahat and then isasata na lang. I don't know, you know, some other way to power all of the fans that they want. And 5 fan headers is pretty generous, and again, and it's nice to have them on these boards. Tapos may option ka pa na gamitin pang water pump header. So lahat na nabanggit ko, pareho yun sa both motherboards. The only thing I could find na pinagkaiba dun sa dalawang boards, aside from their, you know, color design, yung si Extreme 4, kaya niya up to 4733 MHz na RAM. Tapos ito si PG Velocita, 4666 MHz of RAM. But really, that's a, it's just a difference on paper. Sa totoong buhay, you don't want to get speeds past 3,800 megahertz ng RAM para sa Ryzen because the Ryzen chip design can't, you know, doesn't deal well. It doesn't play well with RAM speeds past 3,800. Pero usually kung Ryzen system ka, okay ka na at 3.6, 3.8. So, itong supported na mas mataas na RAM speeds, you know, maganda pakinggan, but in real life, you probably will never use them. So, yun yung dalawang ATX B55 Mobos, the Extreme 4 and the PG Velocita. We do also have an ITX board. Usong-uso yung ITX ngayon. For yung mga nagsisimula pa lang sa PC building, iba-iba kasi yung sizes ng motherboards. Basically, iba-iba yung system size. Like, kung gusto mo sobrang liit na build, yun yung mga ITX builds. They're a bit pricey. Mas mahal yung mga ITX builds because they're the same speed. Kasing bilis lang ng mga ITX builds, yung mga ATX builds. But the parts are much smaller, so the manufacturers had to figure out how to get the same amount of speed or the same level of speed into a much smaller package. The ITX Mobo is the B55PG ITX/AX. It's actually an MITX format. And it has a lot of the things that its bigger brothers have. So, naka Nichicon caps din siya. Chokes actually on the B55PG ITX are of a higher capacity. Kaya nila nung 90 amps. This is actually quite high and it's nice to have on an ITX board. Hindi naman daw ganun kalaki yung difference between 90 amp capacity and 70 amps. Although yung dun sa Extreme 4 tsaka sa Velocita, 60 amps yun. So just taking note of the differences dito sa ITX board. One interesting thing this board does have na hindi karaniwan sa ITX boards is na yung SATA ports niya naka right angle. Yung ibang ITX boards, hindi ganun. Yan yung standard sa ATX, naka right angles yung SATA, but it sort of hit or miss with the ITX boards. Yung nga kasi sobrang cramped ng space ng ITX boards, the designers really have to change things up a little para mapagkasya lahat. Dito sa B55PG ITX, ka-right angles yung SATA ports. It only has two DIMM slots or two slots for RAM, although, you know, this is not uncommon in ITX Mobos. The PCIe slot is the same as its bigger brothers. It may parang reinforced steel or basta sobrang solid yung feeling nung PCIe slots. The clasp sounds really, you know, tough when you try it out. It does come with Wi-Fi, so out of the box, Wi-Fi ready na si B55PG ITX. This also comes with RGB, ARGB, although just one each. So it has one RGB header and one ARGB header. But I appreciate the effort na, yun nga, kaya nung nandun yung dalawa. The RAM speed actually on this thing is insane. It can handle like 5,100 megahertz. Maganda pakinggan on paper, pero hindi mo naman talaga gagamitin in real life. This thing has three fan headers, two for the CPU, and of those two, one can double up as a water pump header. And then the last header is for the third header is for a chassis fan. So there's only one header for fans here. Again, unlike the 5 in the ATX B55s we looked at. So ayun, three very interesting motherboards from ASRock, and we are trying to stock more ASRock products in the shop. Sa totoo lang, we had na sold out and then now we're trying to get more stock, pero out of stock yung mga gusto namin. But among the three, actually, sobrang interested ako dun sa Extreme 4. The PG Velocita, steady lang yung color scheme for me, but parang for me, the Extreme 4, I like that kind of dark look, you know, aesthetic-wise. And a lot of the cases now, kasi may TG side panel or open air case like the TT Core P3, nakikita mo talaga si motherboard. Aside from the technical specs, you also take into consideration the look of the motherboard when you decide to get one. Yung sikat sa ASRock yung Steel Legend, we looked one of the versions of Steel Legend in the Intel motherboard lineup. We'd be curious to carry it in the shop for the AMD Mobos. Di ako usually na-excite sa motherboards, but actually, yun nga, si Extreme 4, parang na-excite ako nung nakita ko, nung in-unbox ko. Maganda rin specs niya. The Nichicon caps look very sturdy. Sobrang liit lang na bagay, but I really like that may power button si Extreme 4, pati si PG Velocita. So, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.
So, I hope that these basic tips helped you. If you found this video helpful, please drop a like and hit the subscribe button. For your PC needs, consider buying from us, Hardware Sugar, at Lazada, or on our website. You can find links in the description below. And thank you for watching. See you next video.